Create a new project called Unicorn Code that will include all the class file in the project. So here I am going to create an Umbraco package template project, and the name would be umbraunicorn.code. Click next, create. That's it, and just need to make sure that it's built successfully or not. Then we need to create a Google API credentials. So go to the console app. We need to create a new profile. So new project, add a project name. No need to add organization, so just make sure that it's correct, and click create. So it will take time to create a project. After creating project, we need to enable some services for authentication. So here we need a Google Plus API. So go to the library and search for Google Plus API. You will find the list and just enable it. So here enable it, and it will proceeding. Yep, it's enabled, and now we need to create a authentication screen, that app. So need to select external as a user type to for the user, external users, add app name. Add email, or you can select anything. Add logo if it's required. Add home page URL. Here I'm going to add localhost URL. And privacy policy URL. This page is not exist, but adding the URL for now. Also adding terms and condition. So it's not exist, but just adding. Add domain. If domain is not working, localhost. Let's try to remove HTTPS. Another one. Oh no. No, it's not working. Let's add email address, a developer email address for contact information. So just add it. For authorization, I think we need to add some valid domain like .local or something. So let's try it. Unicorn.local. No, it's not working. Let's try unicorn.form. Yeah, that's working. Now need to add scopes. So click on add or remove scope. Select required services scope and let's check other if it's required. No. Yeah, now click on update. Okay, save and continue. Add test user for unpublished app. So this is for testing purpose. You can add multiple test users, but just keep it one for now. Add. Save and continue. You will see the summary at last. You will review it and go to back. Dashboard, back to dashboard. So the app is created. Now need to create credentials for API. So create credentials. Then there is several options, but we need to auth client ID. So just select that. Also, application type would be web application for Umbraco for now. So yeah, change the name. Add URL for JavaScript not required, but authorized redirect URL would be required. So I'm here, I'm adding localhost URL / Umbraco that we need to redirect after login on the Umbraco. So I'm just adding it. I think I have added new URL, just removing anything it's creating. Yep. So authorized JavaScript URL is not required for this purpose. I'm just adding here. Click on create and you will see the credentials like client ID and client secret. You need to keep this secret. Then need to install authentication Google one Nuget package. So just need to install it. Then I have created a new folder and create one class file for Google back office options. And I have copied from the document and just replace it. Adding few references. Okay. Adding another class for extension. So yeah, the code block I copied from Umbraco document. Here we need to add references to resolve the errors, and we need to replace client ID and client secret here what we have on console. I'm just copying it. Okay. So we need to add this project in the main project. So adding project reference. Select unicorn 4. Okay. And now open startup and we need to add here extension that we created. I think we need to build the project to get the references. So I think commenting out to build the project because it will cause issue. Yeah, it's built successfully. Need to check again. Still getting red line, so maybe we need to add reference. So just copying from the file and just adding here. Yeah, and yeah, it's working. Let's build it and run the project again. Open Umbraco. Yeah, you can see the button. Click on the button. And oh, it's a redirect URL mismatch. Open. Okay, so we have added different Umbraco Google sign in. So just copy here and update the API client. Replace Umbraco with the what we have copied. Save. Okay, let's try again. Go to the browser and click on path, refresh page, and yes, it is working, but we need to check with other user because this I have created while the create setup project, so we need to check with new user. Let's open this URL in different browser or incognito mode. Click on Google, try with different user. Oops, fast one is wrong. Yeah, it's working, but getting some errors like authorization, the authorized access to URL. So I don't have authorization for the Umbraco URL. Maybe some identity claims are not created or finding while authentication. You will see the user already created here, but it's disabled. The status is disabled. So we need to approve that as well. So we need to update auto link as well as external login functionalities on provider options. So move to the code. So here I'm going to adding claims what we are fetching from login info, the external login info. Also same thing we are following on external login. So we are getting multiple claims from Google, so we are adding all in the Umbraco as a Umbraco user. So I mean that in for each var claims in next claims, okay. auto link user dot claim. Claim, yeah, claim. Okay, remove from maintenance. We need to follow the same thing for an external login. Is approved equal to true. This will enable automatically when after login. So yeah, copy this block into the other block and change auto link user to user. Same thing. Here also we need to add approve user after login. So user dot is approved equal to true. Okay, build it. Let's open in browser and validate it. So this user are disabled, so let's check and try with this one. Boom, user already logged in, and you can see the dashboard. Don't forget subscribe and like this video. Thank you.